and welcome to Nasai Fashion TV. My name is Nasai and I'm going to be your host for the next 1 hour. I want to take this opportunity to say thank you to everyone for the support over the past 4 weeks. Last week was a tremendous, triumphant day for us all. Yes, we've hit nearly 3K likes. And I know this was never going to be done by myself, and I know I needed support from the whole community. So I want to say thank you to everybody who was taking the time out on their lunch breaks, probably haven't fed their kids, just to actually watch. So I'm so grateful, and I'm appreciative, and I know this movement is going to be a massive change. But I want to say something today. I want to just remind everybody a little bit about what Nasai Fashion TV is about. And you know, sometimes you get a bit lost and a bit confused as things progress. But Nasai Fashion TV is about celebrating Sierra Leonean fashion. But it's easy for us to show that there's talent. But talent that goes nowhere is neither here nor there. Nasai Fashion TV is not only to celebrate Sierra Leonean fashion, but to put it on an international arena. In order for that to take place, we need support from the community. Support can mean wearing a designer's outfit, fabulous. But let's be real, support is buying. Nasai Fashion TV, it's about celebrating, rooting out our fashion designers, and asking for you at home to buy the product. Sierra Leonean fashion is lacking immensely, but we can't go any further if you do not buy. Today Fashion TV is the rawness of fashion. It's the people who are behind the scenes, who create these magnificent outfits that we wear. But they can't go any further if you do not buy. So today's show, we have two wonderful guests. But the most important thing about these two guests is they're gonna ask the community to put their money where their mouth is. I say this because so many people say, well, you know, you want to buy Sierra Leonean creations and you don't know where they are. Well, they're here today on Nasai Fashion TV, and for the past 4 weeks they've been here. But today's guests are not just regular designers. They are designers who are ready for you to buy for your everyday living. Ladies and gentlemen, on Nasai TV today, we have the wonderful, the most exciting designer I've come across for a very long time, the wonderful Abs. Yay! How are you?
I'm good, thank you very much.
Wow. I just want to say he's actually very good looking.
What can I say? I'm glad.
You
thank
are
you very much.
Very good looking.
Thank you.
He's not my brother. I want to say thank you so much for being here today. You know, having you on this show means a lot to me. Obviously, you're one of the duo between yourself and Abbas, who's your brother. And the two of you, you make fashionable clothes for anybody. But what I want to first start off with, before we start talking about your collections, I want you to tell me a bit more about yourself. You know why? Because I was flabbergasted by your level of, I can't find the right word, I'm not going to be straight up, because you know, I'm doing Nasai Fashion TV to put designers like yourself on the international stage. But what amazed me about you was your passion and your resilience about what's happening in the Sierra Leone community in relation to supporting fashion. It's been a hard run for all of us, from models to designers to makeup artists, you can imagine. But before we get into all that, tell me a bit more about about yourself.
Basically, my name is Abs, you know, and a bit about myself. I love football, basically, and I think I have to start from there.
Who do you support?
I support Arsenal. But basically, I've got passion for my country, and I think that means a lot to me. Like, when I see anything to do with Sierra Leone, like, it really, like, inspired me to give support to my country, basically. So I think a bit by myself, it has to be with, like, loving Sierra Leone, trying to give back, and I think I'm very, very humble guy, and I'm kind of, like, have respect and morals for like anyone, like basically I respect literally everyone, and more so like the thing that makes me like or makes us stand out is like the passion we have just to promote Sierra Leone, you know, because I don't want to talk too much about myself, but I like my product, you know, and my intake to speak more for me than just sitting here and saying, oh, I'm this, or I've got this, I've got that. You know, but I'm just here to promote Sierra Leone. You know, I think that is the most important thing for me.
Wonderful. But when I say tell me a bit more about yourself, were you born in Freetown?
Yes, I was born in Freetown, obviously. I was born there, and I came here, I was 15 when I came here, and I loved it. You know, I loved every minute of it, like meeting the Sierra Leone community, because where I live, we don't have that many Sierra Leoneans. I don't even know any. Okay. So basically, so when I come to like Southeast and stuff, I do like enjoy it, because you see all this like the cultural stuff, you know, it kind of inspires me to do more, to give back to society. So obviously I was born there, then I came out at 15. And after that, you know, I'm still finding my identity at 15 years of age, 16, 17. Then afterwards, you know, I literally found my identity now. And now here I am, and trying to promote Sierra Leone, and you know, the sky's the limit, basically.
Yeah. Moving from you being coming to London when you were 15, I know you're one part of the duo of Abs. Your brother is not here with us today. He's a wonderful gentleman, his brother. In fact, it's him who I actually knew first before I actually met you. But I do have to say to you that you have blown me away, and I hope that by the time people get to know more of you by the end of the show, that they're going to be actually as amazed by me, you know, by you, you know. The first thing I'd like to ask you, Abs Clothing, what started it all off? What was his inspiration?
Basically, the inspiration from Abs Fashion Collection came from a time I traveled to. It's ironic, you know, that I'm going to say this. I traveled to the Middle East, you know, like in Israel and Palestine. So when I went there and I came back, you know, what I saw there like really struck me to like kind of connect fashion and football. You know, I think there could be like a correlation there. I think that struck me. That's where Abs Fashion started, you know. But like from then, when I came back, you know, I had a chat with my brother. I said, look, you know, this is what I found from there. I think we could do this, basically.
Yeah.
So then I talked to Abbas.
What was you thinking at the time? Were you thinking you were going to do dresses or jeans or jumpers or earrings?
Basically, what was I thinking at the time is I was thinking mainly male fashion, because that's what I know, you know, because I love dressing, I love fashion, I like people to express themselves. That's what I like, you know. So it was mainly male fashion that I wanted to do. So that's what it started. So that's what I thought. No, like doing different dresses.
But what was it about your upbringing that made you want to get into fashion? While everybody, I think for myself, people, when a young woman grows up, you're thinking of doctors and lawyers. I mean, back in my day, you would never think of wanting to be a model. What was it that triggered that you said, you know what, I'm going to be a fashion designer? What was it?
I don't think there is one particular thing that triggered me being like a fashionista, I would say, you know. The thing that actually triggered every all this thing is we said like in Creole, like we grew up with him, he's a bluff man in the bonner, you know, like I was young, like always like looked up to myself, dress up well, you know, like why I grew up, like people are, oh, this guy's always looks up to himself, like yeah, I was young. So I got, I have this thing in my head, okay, yeah, I could actually do this, you know. So I think it all started from that, from like age 9, you know, like taking care of yourself. When your mom gives you money, you save some to buy nice clothes and stuff to make, to dress nice and look good. So I think it all started from that.
I'm happy you mentioned that, because I have known, not just from yourself, from Sierra Leone models, fashion designers, there's something about our parents and our upbringing that has placed us in an unimaginable position on the fashionable scale. I mean, when we think of Sierra Leonean mothers, we think of people with an immense style. And it clearly has rubbed off on us as young people, you know, and we've come international, so some of us, we've carried that forward. What impact or what difference has it made to you being from Sierra Leone as a fashion designer? I mean, you could be from Ghana, let's be real. You could be from Nigeria. What is it about Sierra Leonean upbringing which sets you up, puts you in a position to execute your visionary for fashion?
I think one thing that stands out for me, like my upbringing as Australian, and I think it's the moral qualities that our parents instilled in us.
Fabulous.
You know,
fabulous.
And like the work ethic, like the ethos, like the family that I came from, my mom is workaholic, you know. So like I kind of gain inspiration from her in terms of like fashion, which is very stylish, and she's like working, because you know, like Sierra Leonean society and African society as a whole is very patriarchal, like it's all male dominated, you know. So my mom is one of these few women who like stood up, like, oh, I'm gonna fight for this, you know.
Wow.
And I'll put my trousers on, I'll work, support family and stuff.
Yeah.
But in Africa, it's just men that works. The women, they consider them to be at home. And these are like Yeah, so I think that for me stands out, because I gained inspiration from that, and that's why from that I decided like I'm going to like take up studies and do law and change people's mentality, you know, the way they look at women in society. So I want to change that, and changing that with fashion, I think that is the way forward, you know, for women not to be seen like the way they used to be seen.
Oh, wow.
You know, like they can express themselves.
Yeah.
It's not just about women in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Women can actually go out there. They can be lawyers. They can be doctors. They can be whoever, you know.
I love that.
So these are like inspiration that
so
I came from.
Your mother's inspired you. The fact that your mom was a go-getter is an inspiration behind you and your brother getting together and making a collective for people, like women. You know, I know you do men and you do women's clothes.
Yeah.
Now, I just want to go now, moving forward, how did you and your brother partner in this project, in creating this fashion line? How did you guys come together? I got a sister, and I can't imagine having a conversation with my sister saying, oh, Namusu, we're gonna go do a fashion line, yeah? So where did it come that you was having a conversation, not about football, obviously. He doesn't like Arsenal, no?
No,
I knew it.
No, he's a Liverpool supporter.
He's a Liverpool supporter.
Yeah, he's a
Liverpool
supporter.
Okay, so it's a totally different.
Yeah.
Okay, so how did this fall?
This thing, like I said earlier, it formed from my visit to the Middle East. That's how this thing formed.
Between you and your brother?
No, that initially I went there. When I came, I had the idea, okay, I need to do this. Seeing this, those kids running, like playing with football, t-shirt, like ripped up and stuff. I'm like, okay, you know, I could do something like this. You know, maybe sew this a bit here, do this design and stuff.
How old were you roughly when you went?
I was 18.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so when I came back, I called him, I said, Abbas, you know, look, I've got this fabulous idea. I think we could do something. We could actually change the way like kids like dress in terms of like football. This is what the initial idea was, like dressing, you know, making nice football clothes for kids and stuff. That's how we started.
I hope you didn't make no one wear pink suits.
No.
Football?
Not yet. Absolutely not yet. Yeah, but that's how the idea started.
Yeah, of course.
And obviously, since then, we've just been having like lots of like debates, war and war. Like as you can imagine, like when two people are into business, everyone's got their own different ideas. Yeah. So it will be waking up midnight, 2 a.m, call me. Oh, you know, I thought about this stuff. You know, can we do this like this? Do that like that? I said, okay. Let me have a think about it. Then in the morning, then I'll come up like, oh yeah, that was a fabulous idea. So we kind of complement each other in that way, because he thinks differently, I think differently.
Yeah.
So we come together.
Wonderful.
I think that's how all this thing started.
Wonderful. So you've come to London, you've gone to the Middle East, okay? You've been inspired by these kids running around, and you've decided that you and your brother is going to come together and make a fashion label. Now, the next question I would have for you is, at that moment, did you think that it could be on an international arena? Like we've got the Gucci's and the Versace's. Was that behind any form of thinking?
To be honest with you, it didn't struck my mind that we would take it like international level.
Okay.
Our main concern was to establish ourselves around the Swahili community.
Okay.
Because they say charity begins at home. It's really, really important that whatever you do, your people has to be the number one people that will support you. Our main concern was to establish around the Swahili community, then take it to the African community, then subsequently the world.
Absolutely.
So that's how this whole thing, like, that's our aim.
So that brings me to my next important question. What is fashion to you? What does fashion represent to you?
Fashion is just an expression of who you are. That's what I put it as. You know, it depends on what people think of fashion. Fashion can mean different things for different people because we have different interpretations for literally everything.
Yeah.
So for me, fashion means like expressing yourself, you know, expressing yourself in a positive way. You know, stylish, you know, confident. You know, this is what fashion means for me. And I think that sounds a good message for people out there. Go out there and express yourself.
Yeah?
You know? Yeah.
I like that about you. You know, it almost, it's a thing to me that I'm really, really impressed by you. Because in our community, everybody always likes to be politically correct. Everybody likes to sound, I'm the good guy. And one thing about you, it's your humility and honesty in the way you do it. Fashion, as you've explained, it's about an expression. In the collection that you have brought with us today, let's start with this. You do jeans, abs clothing. Tell the audience a bit more about the products which you create. Jeans.
We do make jeans for both women and men, and we do nice jumpers.
And, you know what he said? He said we do nice jumpers.
Yeah, we do
nice.
We do
very nice.
We do nice jumpers. And
I
recommend people to give us a chance. Just try our stuff. It's not me saying that. Just saying we do nice jumpers. When you do try them out, you actually know. We do nice jumpers because this thing, they fit your body, you know, and the texture means a lot. For us right now, it's not just about making money, it's about building our reputation. Mm-hmm. And I think when you're into fashion, it's not just making money because this Gucci or Armani, they've made their name. So now even little thing that doesn't look nice, itself because they've built their reputation. So for us now, reputation means a lot. So that's why we're putting all our effort in terms of quality into our product. So I recommend that everyone should go out there and try them. And then we recommend everyone to give feedback as well. Are welcome.
Okay,
well,
while we are
looking, I think that's what I'm going to kick in. I've been wearing these jeans. And I'll tell you what, mate. I'm looking proper sexy. No, I'm telling you, these jeans, and everybody who knows me, I'm a sucker for a goodie. And these jeans, being a slim cut or straight cut, I have yet to find any jeans that has done justice for me. And the thing about these jeans, they are not just for the slim cut. If you're round and special, I stand no chance. Because these jeans are on the money. And like you said about feedback, you are here with me today because of the feedback. No, I haven't got a boyfriend since I got the jeans. So, they're fabulous. They are a cut above the rest. Excuse the pun. But it's a cut above the rest. There's no jeans. I have tried whether it be Armani. I don't think I can afford them anyway. I had a pair of Gucci. I've had a pair of Versace jeans. Never in my entire existence has this jean not only changed the way I look, but the way in which I feel. So when you talk about expression, they have really made me feel expressionate about my feelings. They're so feminine, so beautiful, just make you feel like, oh. That was one of my reasons for having you, because it was almost like I slided into, like, you know what, cushion. Because it was just perfect. And to know that a Sierra Leonean designer from our own village, we own Conti, there's an Aquile, right? Yeah. Oh, we make a talker. We own Conti for make our wedding kind to our sister, they make a feel that kind with it. I swear to God. And I make myself, I don't be no person safe.
Can we take some comments from comments? Time for some comments. We have quite a few people are logging on. Bob the Buya says hello. Cheryl Blyden says video not a play. Mama Oni says hello. Bob the Buya says great movement. Samuela James Nasa, you're looking absolutely fabulous. Beautiful dress, darling. Go so. Thomas says, please speak louder, darling. We can't hear you. You look really fab, though.
Thank you.
So we have to remember to speak louder.
Sorry, guys.
Thank you, Elise. DJ Metro, Liverpool. Arsenal. Zaire Sherry says, beautiful dress. Absolutely stunning. Aisha Thomas, I can't hear. Please speak out.
Sorry.
Cuckoo says, that's like the dress, girl. Aisha Thomas says, you all look stunning.
Thank you.
DJ Metro says, Nasa, you're looking great. Congratulations and keep it up. Well done. Gusto! Prophet Fitzgerald Johnson says, keep up the good work. Susie Cork, wow, Nasa, not kill we all. Love that dress. You look stunning. Mama Oni, stunning. Love the dress.
Thank you, Oni.
Samuela James says, yes, exactly what I said last week. On the money. Keep one expression. And Musu says, definitely copying this style of dress. You look amazing.
Thank you. Thanks, guys. Moving. Thanks, actually. That was nice. I actually appreciate. See, humility sometimes. Sometimes, especially where we're doing this live, you get so many comments and people almost start to believe with this virtual world that we're living in. But I know with Fashion TV, people are actually making comments based on facts. You know, it's not just because somebody posted maybe this would say, thank you, I like you. So I know everybody's actually taking a heed, which makes a massive difference. And I'm really grateful for all the comments. My next question to you, Mr. Ahansa, or should I shout? My next question to Mr. Ahansa, apart from the obstacle that you're gonna have for marrying me, but what obstacle? What obstacle have you endured with Abs Fashion? Let's just talk about first within the community. What obstacles have you had to endure?
Basically, we've encountered or endured like a lot of obstacles within the Sierra Leonean community. I think to start with, when we started this movement or having this Abs Fashion collection, we started with like an aim of like promoting Sierra Leonean fashion out there. So that was our aim. So when we have our product, we start going to like all these outings, selling our product there, you know. But people start knocking us back, like, oh, is this, what's that app stand for? I'm like, this is our name. You know, what does it supposed to mean? Then I'll turn back. What does Armani or Gucci supposed to mean? These are people's name, you know, and if you don't give us time. Yay! you know, these are people's names. Yeah. You know, you gotta give people chance for them to excel. Yeah. You know, then in few years time, you won't be asking what apps meant, you know? You know, it's like combination of both of our names. So this is really important. So we encountered like obstacles from there. And up to now, we're encountering obstacles. Like for the past 6 months, I think we haven't hit our targets, you know, because of like time management. Because I've been busy with studying and literally just finished, obviously. And I haven't had time to like invest, you know, because this, you got to invest so much time in terms of social media and marketing on all this. Yeah. You know, when you have another job, it makes life difficult. So we've had a lot of challenges, but we've actually rose from those challenges. And recently we just had like a massive news, like, you know, that I would encourage everyone to get their eyes peeled. You know, a massive news coming like for apps and fashion collection. And it's really important to the Sierra Leonean community because you guys just get your eyes peeled. Something
we can't
remarkable
wait.
Would happen soon.
I'm confident in it. Yeah. I mean, you say something remarkable is about to take place within your collection and what you're doing. I'm confident of that. You know, the excellency in these jeans. I want to throw something out to the community. In my research before I did Nasai Fashion TV, many people have said that they did not know who the Sierra Leone fashion designers were. Some people, I would say to them, so why don't you buy your top from here? They say, well, we're not sabi, we don't know them day. So I thought to myself, let me try and get more and more, get the Sierra Leonean designers to come onto this show. But the community is still not buying. The community is still not buying. And it beggars belief. Why we are in a commute in England and we have Sierra Leonean designers who you just say something like I shall be business, but it's not so I shall be you, it's not so close for go wear wedding. Oh, this not everyday wear. This is, there should be no question on whether you're going to invest 40 30 quid on a pair of jeans from your own people. It beggars belief that we have to sit here today and ask and literally plead, because I'm ready to beg, for the community to say, you know what, for the next 2 years, every jean I wear, I'm going to buy it from Abs
Clothing.
The most, it's an everyday wear, bearing in mind we wear it to work, we wear it to the park, we wear it with the kids, we wear it everywhere. If you want to wear, if you step in my way, I'm going to wear that. So, right now, I'm saying to the community, put your money where your mouth is. So many people say they want to support salon fashion. All that means for saying I'm not able to spend 30 pounds, let me buy a pair of these jeans, a pair of these women fitted jeans. Another collection over here, not to mention the jumpers. And as you would know, Abs collection, it can develop whether to dresses. We need the community to buy.
Buy.
I need you guys to buy. Abs needs you to buy. When you go and buy your jeans in Topshop, Pakistan is getting that money. India, them too, they're getting some of it. China, £50 for me, they're getting. None of that money is entering in Africa. I'm not saying this is not about being prejudiced, this is just about saying we need to realize the economics of our country. So I'm hoping after today, Abs clothing. Everyone watching right now, am I speaking loud enough?
Yes, yes, yes.
Everyone watching right now, you could make your to yourself today that from here on in, for the next 2 years, your jeans are coming from Abs collection. It's not expensive to the point that you cannot afford.
It's about people realizing the economics. We've got to spend our pounds amongst ourselves. But I don't want to make you all feel that I'm upset. I don't want anybody to feel. I just want the community to realize enough is enough. I can't have a splendid man like yourself going through all this hard work and our community is not necessarily embracing and buying. What would you like to see more from the community?
What would I like to see more in the community? I think it's love, basically. I think it's more important. Love is the most important thing that you can find out there. You know, I think that's the most important thing. If we love one another, I think like this thing that you're explaining about buying the gyms, it will be like second nature. They will be coming to you just like that. You know, because when you love Sierra Leone, you know you need to love NASA TV. You need to love Abs Gym. It's like the support.
Yes.
You know, if you might not like my gym, you might not like the style.
Yes.
You know, but because of the love, that would encourage you to buy it. Then maybe when you try it, then you fall in love with it.
Yes, of course.
So this is just try.
Yes. You know, and that's it. Your word you said, just give it a go, guys. Mm. Come on, man. This community, everyone in this building is wearing jeans today. Probably 80% of the people on the street are wearing jeans. But none of that money is going to Freetown. None of it. How is it going to go back to Freetown? Or maybe Makeni? Or go to Funk? Any sign now? Where is the money? I'm not trying to say it's about just spending your money. It's about investing. We need to let our copper go to our own posse. Jeans are everyday wear. And the reason why I've got this gentleman here today is because everybody said, yeah, with the support, pass them their wedding for the I shall be. Yes, with the support, pass that christening for the I shall be. Well, no, my guests today are everyday buys. So if you really are supporting, I think we should be getting someone asking for the sort code and account number.
Yeah, oh yes, yeah, they are. Oh, all right, that was a joke.
Okay.
All right.
We need.
Can we have some comments? Are you ready for some comments?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Go okay. On. Patrina says beautiful dress, Nasai. Hamid says Nasai, well done and keep up the good work. Margaret says I like. Zaire says well done, Abs Clothing. Keep believing yourself. Keep going.
Yes.
Professor Johnson says Sierra Leoneans need to learn to support each other and be each other's keepers.
Oh.
And Zaire says, can we see an example of the jeans and the jumpers?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Susie is asking, where can we buy? That's why I wanted to get to the comments.
We're ready to sell now.
And Alice is saying, can I know where his shop is? Well done, bro. Samuela's asking, does Abs Jeans design jeans also for fuller figure ladies?
Oh yes!
A plus size range. I'm yet to find that special jeans to wow me.
Sammy! Is that Samuela?
Yeah. Samuela said that, yes.
Samuela!
Tell us again, size. Miguel,
Ice care size.
Ice care size.
Ice size. By the time you worn this jeans, Samuela, I retire. I retire. They are fabulous. They do sizes.
There we go! It's coming out! It's coming out! It's coming out! Joshua says he does designs for all sizes. We're getting them out now. We're getting some designs out. Samuela, buy from where? Internet or shop?
Samuela, I'm coming to your house. Sammy. Oh God, man, your ass. Sammy, tell us that we'll be there in about half an hour. Sammy, we're going.
You can come to Peckham. We've got a shop there, in Jalo's shop, in Truman Road. We've got a shop there. You can come there. Then you can go to Instagram. You know, we've got Facebook as well. Then obviously we go to people's houses. We've got store like in Covent Garden. We go there. You can meet us there. You know, or you can just like us on Facebook and ask for details. Then we'll definitely come to your house and just show you. You know, because right now we're just starting, so we go to people's houses and show them the quality. Then they know exactly where we're coming from.
That's so.
And you know what? A really important point there. You said, where can you get it?
How are they gonna sell it if you don't buy? Do you know what I mean? How are they gonna sell it if you don't buy? People have to buy. You have to buy in order for that person to generate economics. Am I the right word? Money.
Yes.
Yeah. To generate money in order for that person to now invest that money on a shop. It's a double-edged sword. Not easy. So we need people to buy. You want to go on East Street Market and just type pink shirt, salon designer. It should take you straight to East Street. But we can't. The person, a designer is not just going to take a hit when you're fighting to sell £20 jeans or you're fighting to sell a £30 top. So it's a case of, it's a double-edged sword. You say you want to support the movement, but you're going to buy. I tell you, I'm ready to retire today out of public, in any public engagement. If every individual who is watching today buys, we're going to get rid of me today. Yeah, if everyone watching today buys a product, I guarantee you I will get away from me social media. If you're going to get rid of me, that's the way to get rid of me. Because I just need these guys to get paid. Because by them being paid, fashion is an international arena for us. And if he gets big, it means that he's going to take Fatu with it up yonder, Fats Matter with it be yonder, as their models. The photographer, they go back. The makeup artist, they fire. But if the designer is not supported, he's not able to take nobody. Nobody can be on that international stage. The beginning is to buy from the designers. Would you agree?
I totally agree. Just one key note I want to mention there. Like you said, when people, you're encouraging people to spend. The most important thing why I think people should spend, you know, like spend their money on apps fashion, because we're on the verge of creating, you know, soon to be like having like a charity back home. And for every pound spent on this apps fashion jeans or t-shirt or any of our range, 30p goes to that charity.
So and 30 pence?
30 pence goes to that charity.
Oh, fabulous.
And what that 30 pence does, it does create and empower the youth of our country. Because that's where, you know, because like what she said, we might retire and the youth is the future of the country, you know, so we got to give back to society. So the concept behind this app fashion is giving back to Mama Salon. So please, mi fambule, una help we support this.
Please.
And push forward. No, if the pikinem na straight, them Ebola pikinem, you understand? We got to kill that stigmatization there. You know, help them create like a very good environment to so them go educate themselves, you know, so we are empower them. So every 30p, every pound spent, 30p goes to this charity, and this charity helps them.
Oh, I mean, this guy, you've blown me away today with everything that you've said, and I would like you to tell the community what you would want from them as a collective in supporting Sierra Leone fashion. Not to normal of say, oh, you said you get one person, I make you a shobio, you get one somebody over that. What would you as a designer want from the community in promoting Sierra Leone fashion and its designers?
I think, first of all, like I mentioned earlier, love and social cohesion, where we come together. You know, we have harmony. You know, we love one another. Like, we support. Like, if NASA TV is doing something, we go there in numbers, support him. You know, if Act Fashion is doing something, we go there, support him. Yeah. I think that social cohesion means a lot.
Yeah.
You know, where we kind of empowering ourselves. You know, it doesn't matter if I'm making Pulnado or Mr. A is doing wedding.
Yes.
We go there in numbers and support him. Like, people, we need to send a message out there to like other nationals that these people, they are tight-knit people, they are very close. It's not a place where you can just come and jump into. You know, you got to come for barriers.
Yes.
And this barrier is the love barrier, I called it. You know?
Yeah. you've just proven just what makes us great people. I'm so grateful for Abs Clothing and what you lot are doing, and it's just right up my street, everything that I believe in. And I just really hope after today, everybody is going to buy the whole Salon community. Please, I don't need to say please, you know why? The world speaks for itself. Purchase a pair of Abs jeans. Every pound,
30p, and that pounds goes to the charity.
It's going to go to a charity to support people who have been Ebola sufferers and families and integrate them back into society. So it's not just for profit. It's for the development of the community of Sierra Leone as a whole. So please, guys, please, please, please. I'm going to say please because you know what? I need to pull your hand. Only after you've gone into the cotton and your body, you see, and you feel nice, will you realize the value of these products. Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to say thank you to this gentleman.
Can we have a few comments before he goes?
I'm the only one giving him comments.
Yeah.
Is there anyone who wants to give you comments? Oh, no.
Sorry, just before you go. Hamid is saying, Nasai, it's well said, Sierra Leone needs to seriously support one another. Boktu Mbuya says, strongly agreed with such statement. We need to support each other to grow, and teamwork makes the dream work. For our community... Let's go! For our community to have growth, we must invest collaboratively within our community in order to grow economically. Boktu Mbuya, Nasa, you look stunning in that gorgeous dress.
Oh,
and
gosh.
Mr. Salon Kalon says, Gosso!
Bye!
Samuela says, okay, hon. Yes, darling. Samuela says, I sure will be here. Fantastic, love it. Missy J says, hey!
Hey,
Missy J! Alice Thomas says they look good quality. We'll definitely find you. Nasai, I love your shoes from Marima Junior Parade. Fantasy says I love it. Boktu Mbuya, you're absolutely great products. Very impressive and inspiring.
Oh.
So maybe you want to show them again before you leave. Let me just finish the comments again. Samuela, if you're looking for a plus size model, I'm available.
Oh!
No shame in my game.
Oh,
it's called support. I'll do it for free to push the label. Why not? Fashwa says, they are very good quality, and I say this from experience. They don't rip, don't shrink in the wash, and still maintain it. Fashwa! And she said they still maintain its good, its new look after every wash. You guys need to try both his trousers and jumper. That's good! Samuela James says, I love people that give back. There's no greater joy than giving back. Love it. I salute you, sir. And Miriam says, this is what we need in our opportunity. Yes. Support and unity. Haja, hi Haja! Says, love seeing your product abs. I've been in the fashion industry for over 10 years and I would love to purchase some of your jeans and wear it to work and be proud to say this outfit is from my hometown brother and they are fab designers.
Haja,
please have the prize and show them, show some love. We love you, Haja!
Haja!
Haja! Haja! Haja! Haja! Haja! Haja. So that's Haja's asking for the prize range. She wants to support.
Yeah, that's what we just
support the movement. We love you, Haja. Thank you. Sorry, Karen.
Price range.
So if I wanted a pair of these ladies' jeans, how much would that cost?
Yeah, £30.
Oh wow.
£30.
And as for the gents.
The gents is £35.
Whoa! I was gonna say, whoever buys the jeans now, I'm going to go out with them. But then I thought nobody would go out with me. They're probably going to say, we're forgetting. I don't want the jeans.
Can I just throw this out there? It's like an offer. You know, the first 25 people, like from now, live, we're live.
Whoa! That's so! Susie Cock, I'm very interested. That's so!
First 25 people, I'll do it for them for £20.
Whoa!
Oh, well,
bye! 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 journalist Nasai Fashion TV to get £20 on the jeans.
Nasai Fashion TV.
Definitely, for you to get that discount, you need to go to Nasai Fashion TV.
Well, yo.
Then you can get that £20 discount.
Gesso! I need two now from Alice. Gesso!
We're going to send your number over because many people are actually texting in private messages for your contact detail. Are you gonna give them your number?
Yeah, my number.
No, I thought I'll give them that. Yes. 999. So anybody who's text messaging for the contact number, we're gonna send the numbers to you. And I mean, Sangrella, you know you're gonna be in the photo shoot already. And Susie's gonna do the jury for the photo shoot. Okay. Yeah. Oh, I know we're a full-on team, you know, we're just like, you know, this is the greatest team in London town. Thank you so much for your time, your patience with the community, but also the fact that you're very forgiving and you're willing to give the community a chance.
Yeah.
And please bear with us, I'm fighting, but I need a new wig because God, like 4 weeks with this wig, I'm good. I need a new wig to just keep the fight. Just thank you. I want you to just look in that camera. I'm going to give you 30 seconds to tell the people at home what makes Abjeen the cut above the rest and why they need to buy yours. Ready, steady, go!
What makes Abjeen stands out? The material, the texture, because it's like 90% elastic. When you wear that, it stretches. It can fit anyone. It doesn't matter your size, your age, you know, so that makes it stands out. And the quality, like the lady just said earlier, when you wash them, you know, they still look like new. So that makes it stand out. And the whole concept behind the apps jeans, you know, I think that's what people should go for. And most importantly, it's supporting Sierra Leone. You know, when you buy this, you're helping the kid back. So that's what I'm doing.
Needs forgiveness for your community because so many people have failed to support. We've got international people sponsoring this gentleman, but our own people are still failing to purchase enough. Not gonna lie to you, we've got a lot of people walking down the street wearing Abs jeans already. I've been one of them quite a few times. So we just want more. The bottom line level, I'm not necessarily, NASA Fashion TV is not here to say we get talents. We get talent in Boku, but talents will run out if they don't get paid. I'm serious, you know, I'm not trying to beat around the bush about anything. I'm just trying to say it as it is. And the truth of the matter is we're lacking on the international stakes because you're as important as your last like. So if no one didn't get you a like on your Facebook page, sharing your page, well, you're definitely not gonna be on no international stage. So we need people to like, comment, share, and buy. That was really exciting. So thank you for being a part of it. Thank you so much.
Samuela is having a one black, please.
Okay.
Size will be at Alice's inbox as well.
Inbox.
So.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, Samuela, Alice, they got it.
Yeah.
It will be. I'll be around tomorrow. Not with the gentleman, but with the jeans. Now, I just need to say something before we bring on our next guest, and it's about the outfit. I got messed up last week because my most stunning look, I forgot to mention. Oh, that's like, what a mistake. I forgot to say a thank you to my designer, who last week, the dress I was wearing was from Mahmoud's Designs in Freetown.
Gosso! Mahmoud! 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 Mahmoud!
apologize. It was all so excitable that day that I just missed to, you know, tell this gentleman what a wonderful designer he is and how he has brought me to life. So because I didn't say thank you last week, I decided to dedicate this whole week and wear another Mad Moves outfit. Mad Moves, Mad Moves, Mad Moves, Mad Moves, Mad Moves. So the outfit I'm wearing today is again from a Sierra Leonean designer. His name is Mad Moods Design, Hamoudi in Freetown. And this is one of his collections. So, I mean, this gentleman... Did you say Versace? I thought you did that. Mad Moods. So he's great. If I just want to just give a little spin, a little turn. And this gentleman has created this for me, and I just want to let everybody know this is a Sierra Leonean designer. His name is Mad Moods. He's in Freetown, and right now, Mad Moods!
Mad Moods! Mad Moods! Mad Moods! Mad Moods! Gusto!
So I just want to just drop that out there. Thank you so much for everybody who's watching. We're going to now move on to our next guest. Our next guest is a very dear lady to me. We first met her at Joy Sierra Leone when we did Taste of Sierra Leone. And the Taste of Sierra Leone, as everybody knows, it's all about celebrating Sierra Leonean designers. And this year will be our third year. And next year will be our third year. So we met this lady back, was it last year? And I was flabbergasted, quite frankly. The fact that I spend probably 30 quid a month on bath products, you know, go to Boots, sometimes it's the off license if I can't afford much. But to know that we had a lady within the community that was actually making soaps, bath oils, sprays and creams, candles, I was shocked. But what I was more shocked at was its quality. As we've done Nasai Fashion TV, I've had many phone calls. I did a research before I even started this show, and everybody said, we don't know who that are designer then. We don't know so I could go by them thing then. So I decided today is a big day, because as everyone who is watching, most people watching saying they're ready to support Sierra Leonean fashion. Some said they didn't know who the designers were. So I found the designers and I brought them. But in my research, some people said, well, you know, you only tell where they go to the designer if I get for buy a shabby, if I get for buy clothes for christening. Well, guess what? This is perfect. Because the thing about our next guest, it's not whether you're going to a party or a christening, it's if you want to smell nice. You want to wash, everybody washes every day. This lady who's going to be my next guest is a lady I am ready today to really see in the community who is ready to support. Ladies and gentlemen, my next guest, the cream of the crop itself. The lady who's gonna make you all wonder why you're not spending your last £10 on Sierra Leonean designer's work. Lady and gentlemen, I bring to you Mahawa! Pleasure to have you around now. You always make me feel calm.
That's good.
every time I ever write, it's like everybody keep quiet. Thank you so much for today. I mean, when we first met at Taste of Sierra Leone,
you were somebody who, let's be honest, you were just on the ball most of the things, you know, you knew what you wanted. And that was one of the few times that I'd worked with Sierra Leonean designers. So to know that you were so professional, what to expect and what not to, what you didn't want, you know, I was very impressed that we had you on that scale. My reason for having you here today, Mahawa, is I may have had one designer here and they make clothes, and someone will call me and say, well, then clothes are too expensive. I just be buying them, I don't go able for buying for now, I get ready. So I brought you on here today because most people say one, product can be expensive, and two, it's only once in a while that they need it. But today's interview with this lady, and you're going to explain more about what you do, I think everybody watching is ready to buy now. Even if you haven't got a wedding to go to, I'm sure you're going to watch tomorrow, right? So, before we go any further, Mahawa, tell us a bit more about yourself. Who are you? Where have you come from?
Hey.
Obviously from Sierra.
Yes, of course. My name is Mahawa.
Okay.
And I am a soap maker. I'm a product designer, I'm a beauty specialist, and I'm a mom.
Mommy! That's the great thing about being a designer. You can really make it to work, right?
Yeah.
So, what started, first of all, what's the name of your label?
So the name of the company is called The Soap Connoisseur, and we are a specialist organic toiletry company. We specialise in creating personal care products.
Louder please, the audience say louder, speak up.
So we are The Soap Connoisseur, we are a specialist organic toiletry company. We specialise in creating handmade and personal care products. We do anything from soaps to body scrubs to body butters, so anything to take care of your body really, so your personal care. Body, and that's what we do.
Yeah. With soap connoisseur, what was it? Where, how did it all start?
So
I mean, we all have a bath, but not every time I'm at the bath. Not every time I'm in a bath, I think I'm gonna make bath. I'm gonna make soap. So what pushed you to want to make soaps?
Okay, so the soap connoisseur started about 2-3 years ago, after I actually had my daughter. That's actually the reason I started.
Okay.
I actually couldn't find any products that were not, had, didn't have any chemicals in them.
Okay.
So, and she had really, really bad dry skin.
Oh, so your daughter had really bad
dry skin. So
hence.
That was how it started. I got tired of the dripper base, I got tired of what the GP was giving me, and I decided to go into my kitchen. Do some research and discover that I could you can make soap.
Wow.
And other products. And then I spent about 2 years teaching myself and learning the process, learning how to make the product, learning the science behind the products, and then we and then I launched last year. Whoa!
Situation with your daughter, it inspired you. So what was it? What was it about your daughter that made you want to get into soap?
Well, she had dry skin. She had,
okay.
It was quite really
intense.
Bad dry skin.
Was it intense?
It was quite intense.
And nothing the doctors gave you?
Nothing worked. I didn't like the smell.
Okay.
And then I just realized just how much chemicals and just different synthetics are in our everyday products.
Okay.
Even the Johnson & Johnson, there's quite a lot of things in them
That
aren't actually good for our skin. So I just started researching, and from research it grew. And
you fell in love with it?
I fell in love with the process.
Wow.
I've always liked working with my hands.
Okay.
So discovering that you could make soap from shea butter, coconut oil and olive oil was the bonus.
Oh, wow.
part on top of it.
Oh,
so,
wow.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Don't give a secret away.
No, not
yet. Okay. So, whatever has led, your daughter not his daughter's situation pushed you into wanting to find better products to help her skin.
Yes.
And this landed you to realize you could actually make your own products which would better your daughter's skin.
Yes.
But luckily for us, it's going to better all of us as well. Now, you said you launched a year ago.
Yeah.
We're going to look, these are your products, some of the products that we have here.
Yeah.
Now, I'm going to start with a product I use every day.
Okay.
That is my product. Yeah. Okay? And this is the soap.
That's soap.
And that's soap as well. Now, I got the big one a year ago. I'm still using that soap. It is phenomenal. Tell me a bit more about this soap.
So all our soaps have a shea butter, olive oil, and coconut oil base. That's the base ingredient from every soap that we make.
Okay.
And then we use organic essential oils to fragrance all our soaps. So everything is as pure and as organic as possible. The soap making process actually takes about 4 weeks.
Wow, this takes about 4 weeks to make?
It takes 4 weeks to be ready for use. So after it's been made, we then leave it to set for 4 weeks. So it goes through a 4 week curing process.
Wow. And what ingredients are in this particular soap?
So this particular one is our chocolate and tangerine soap. So it's got chocolate and organic tangerine essential oils.
Okay. It smells beautiful as well. It's really, really fluffy and it's just, you know, one thing I love about this soap, it don't make you feel dry.
No.
It doesn't make you feel dry at all. You just almost feel like you're already oiled.
Yes.
You know? I mean, if I wanted to buy this, if one of our viewers want to buy one right now, how much would that cost?
They range at £4, so they
reach. £4!
So you're telling me. £4. I'm gonna have this soap.
Yes.
£4. For £4, I can now put my money where my mouth is, in the sense that I support Sierra Leonean fashion. So everyone who's watching this show should be able to buy this soap. So who's gonna be our first buyer? £4. Who's gonna be our first buyer? You know why I say this? Because we are not here to hold no prisoners. I am here for one thing and one thing only. Let our pennies be spent amongst ourselves. If some think some products are expensive, well, we got a product here today, it's £4. How much it cost for a pack of cigarettes? £4.22 or something like that. Now, the cigarette is for one day. The soap is for four weeks. I've had the big chunk one and I've had it nearly a year. I've still got that soap and I'm still used. I used it today because I just obviously, if you're going to sell something, you're going to say I used it today. You know, I used it this morning. And this soap, it is fabulous.
Thank you.
It is
thank
fabulous.
You.
Can we just move on to can I have a candle, a lighter, so we can light this candle? This is the butter, right?
Yeah, it's the body butter.
Okay. Yeah.
So this is a body butter specifically designed for people with dry skin and other skin types as well.
Mm-hmm.
And it's got shea butter again, coconut oil, but we added another ingredient called grapeseed oil, which is another type of oil. So all our ingredients are plant-based. So we make sure that they're all plant-based or vegetable-based or botanical. So they're all from the earth, basically.
Wow.
So everything is as natural as you can get it. And this is about 48 hours to make. So everything is made by hand.
And you're making them at home?
I do make all the products at the moment.
Wow.
So.
No, that's fine. That's fine.
Yeah,
we're going to get onto that a bit later.
Yes, everything's made by hand. So everything's, you know, organic-based. We try to keep it as organic and as pure as we possibly can. We make sure that all the products are essential oil based, so they're all fragrance with essential oils. And this one's our cherry blossom butter.
I think I'm going to take that today because I haven't got that one. Let's look at it. That's beautiful, though. That's beautiful. So, if someone want to buy that now, how much is it going to cost?
That range is at £14.
What? Wow. That's a good price. You know why? That is a very good price. So, £14. For £14, they can have this.
Yeah, that's 200 grams.
200 grams.
Yeah.
And how long, if somebody wanted this now, how long would it take for you to deliver?
Oh, we can deliver straight away.
So, I just need the address. Just give me the address if you mind the corner. That's it.
Yeah, can we get some comments? We gotta go to comments.
Oh, comments, comments.
Right, I need to go back to the last few comments. Samuela says one black size. I think he's talking about the jeans. Please inbox me. That's true talk, Nasai. Support, 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 and buy.
Buy, buy.
Amin was saying, hey, as a designer myself, I'm very happy to support your product and wear them just to start the ball rolling.
Yes.
I'm in support for Sierra Leone fashion all the way. Hami! 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 Susie says, that guy is making waves in Freetown, my moods.
Yes.
Samuela says, heard about him, will hurt him when I get to Freetown. Need to rock one of his designs. Samuela says, thank you, Fashwa. Alice, speak louder, and then we got that message.
Sorry, Auntie.
Yeah. Susie Cork says, I actually Googled them and I was impressed by their presentation and work. Nasai, thank you for shining light on such talent.
Yeah.
From our beloved Sierra Leone.
Yeah.
Marma Oni says, well done, Mahawa. Tried your product and they're excellent. Wow. I still have one of your containers. Keep up the good work. Marma! 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 Marma!
And you see the go on.
Yeah, Susie says, proof that you can do anything you put your mind to. Do you do organic black soap like the ones from Sierra Leone? Because they smell, because they smell them here, but they ain't really the same. Yeah, okay, let me just finish your comments. Marima Oni says, a sigh of an amazing entrepreneur finding a solution to a problem. Mariama T says, please, where can I get to buy them?
Mariama, I'm coming on your ass!
Miriam! 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 Susie says, I can't stand Lush. I am sure these are better. Cuckoo says, wow, thank you, Nasai, for shedding light on such great talents from Sierra Leone. I only use organic products on my skin.
Oh, you know Cuckoo is creme de la creme. Cuckoo, yeah. Cuckoo ain't wearing no boots.
You know? Marma's like, me. Alice says, wow, lovely. Where can I buy your products? That's really good. So I've actually shared quite a lot of the pictures and all the on the same comments. Marma says, I need three. Gusto! Marma! 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 Susie says, me! Cuckoo says, I want the soap, Nasai!
Cuckoo, I'm coming for you!
Samuela says, it's amazing how events or experience in our life can inspire us to do great things. Great work. As a mother myself with a child who still suffers from intense eczema, I would like to try your products because I've heard they're really good.
Yeah.
Alice says, I need it now. Alice! 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 Susie says, Sam, that is nasty weather I am. Your daughter, one and only Susie.
Oh, Susie.
Your daughter,
Susie, we love you.
We love you, Susie.
We love you, Susie.
Your daughter will be fine with salt and seawater and salon. So sorry. Hope she gets better. Indeed, try her stuff. They look amazing.
Yeah.
Samuela says, one soap and the body butter for my daughter. Sammy. Just like, please bring it when you're coming. Thanks, honey. Yeah. We'll get on with the comments. We'll get back to these, yeah?
This is a great one, and I need to get one. Now, someone mentioned about the black soap.
Yes.
Yeah. I haven't got
that. So I started experimenting with black soap, the African black soap, and I decided to change it up a bit to add some essential oils to it. Mm-hmm. So instead of the sort of soapy smell that you get, what you get is an essential oil type smell to it. Those aren't out available yet because we're still rolling them out. We're actually looking for testers. So anybody that's interested in testing it out before we roll
I'm
it
ready
out
to go.
As
I'm
product,
ready to test.
We are interested in
and Josephine
is on the back.
And me. Oh yeah, and us. The three of us. We're ready to test. We're ready, we're good to
definitely,
go.
Definitely,
yes. Yeah. I mean the fact that you're actually incorporating the black soap in this collection. It's actually quite cool.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Because
it's quite cool because you know
because it's so easy sometimes when people get on an international level, they forget about where they came from. Yeah. And the fact that you're incorporating something that's very cultural within our community, I mean, some of us, we still think that our skin is never going to be the same unless we get black salt. Mm-hmm. So to know that it's possible for us to go up the road and get it, and it's the same concept and the same way it's being done, then I think it's a win-win-win. The next question I have for you now, I mean, you know, I've spoken to you a lot about what I want to achieve about in this show, and it's great to highlight talent, but talent that's not getting paid is not getting us nowhere. What obstacles have you faced in the community? Can we get some wine?
Are you talking specifically within the Sierra Leonean
community? Yeah, within the Sierra Leonean community, because we're in a bit of a pickle, aren't we?
Yeah,
it's a bit of a pickle we are. What's going on? What have you enjoyed? What's happened?
We've enjoyed different things. I think from our generation, there's a generational gap as well. So what you've got is our generation coming up that's saying that actually, you know, education and getting a degree is not enough, and we want more. So there's also that gap. So you've got this generational gap that's happening between the Sierra Leoneans who were bred in this country. Oh, thank you. who I would say were bred in this country. I was born in Sierra Leone, but obviously I grew up in London. So growing up in London, you see a different life. Yeah. And I think for that, what happens is the system is not enough for us anymore. You know, going to school, getting a degree is not enough. Yeah. So, and we want more, we want to do more, we want to make an impact. So, and what you get is a generational barrier between the older generation who immigrated over here and us who grew up here. And sort of there's this conflict that happens, and we don't know how to overcome, because we need them to actually support us, to push us out there, to get us going.
Yeah.
But if they're constantly trying to push us back into the system, then, you know, we feel like we're at odds with it.
What would you like to see more of? I always ask the guests, what would you like to see more of in the community in relation to fashion?
I think just definitely more of us supporting each other, but also making things that are relevant to us, because you have events that are in the Sierra Leone community, but they're not relevant necessarily to our generation. So we want to see events that are relevant to us, that we can come, that we can contribute to as well. So I think that's one of the things that I'm definitely looking out for, something that's relevant to me, to the people I know, that we can promote. And, you know, we want to promote Sierra Leoneans. We want to promote other businesses, but is it relevant? And also, is it growing us as a people?
I think she's fabulous. We've spoken about this, me, you, and Ice, when we did a taste of Sierra Leone, and it was what it was all about. I mean, I remember Ice like, that's a mile. So to hear you say what you're saying now, we as a people, it just has to change.
Yeah, it has to change.
And I think your product is a product that I believe can change this moment.
Thank you.
Because it's £4 for the soap. So this moment, someone can wake up tomorrow morning and say, you know what? If 50 people bought that soap, do me the numbers, I said two.
Yeah.
And I need it.
50 people by 40.
Yeah,
200.
How much? If I
200.
So, right. If 200 people bought that, 200 people bought the soap, give me the number, someone.
216.
216?
Yeah.
For 200 people?
At
£4.
Oh, no. 50 people at £4 is 200.
800.
Right. So just a very small amount of the people who are watching this show could already put £500 in their pocket. But it's not just the £500. Your soap is going to be on their bathroom. Our ancestors have woken up. Do you know what I mean? People need to buy. Guys, I know it's a cliche, because I'm someone, you're not going to catch me out. I've got this soap at home. I've got these jeans here. I got the jewelry from Soap Susie. I got it. All I just want is to enter everyone's home and to see a soap from a Sierra Leonean designer, and to see an oil. Because if every individual had this soap, we've changed your life. It's that simple. If every Sierra Leonean man purchases one jean, we've changed their life. It's that simple. So please, again, I don't have to say please because it speaks for itself. These products, before we finish off, I want to talk about this product. It's like a killer punch. I could really miss this one. Can someone just put this close up to the camera so they can have a look? This. It's the soap. And just bring it closer to the camera so the guys can see. And you've made that.
Yes, we make that. I've made that.
There's no candle in the soap. Though.
No, they're not candle. They're actually soaps. You can actually bath with them. Wow. I know they look like food, but it's not what our concept is all about.
Oh, is that ice? I think this is your one. Is it the one you
found? My one is lemongrass.
Oh, this is the tea tree. Oh, yeah.
People with oily skin.
So this is tea tree.
Tea tree.
Tea tree and peppermint.
With a oily skin or skin that's breaking out, then this is the soap for you.
So this is a soap. Mm-hmm. Anyone who's got oily skin, breaking out. And tea tree with
peppermint.
Tea tree with peppermint. Our own sister, Ethel. I need to get closer. Can someone get this closer to the camera, please? Our own sister has made this. Tea tree with peppermint. Soap. How much is this soap?
That one's £4 as well.
Who's gonna buy me this soap? I need someone to buy this soap for me. It's £4. £4 for this soap. It's £4. 2 times 2. No, I mean, I that's why I fell
Cuckoo's
in love.
Cuckoo's asking though, where can I buy the products?
Cuckoo is gonna come and get, because Cuckoo's saying it to me.
Yeah.
Tell Cuckoo, I got something for you. I'm gonna have one ready for you, Cuckoo. I'm not saying anything yet. Cuckoo, you got it. Sammy, you got it. Yeah. But just to know you made that. The artistry in itself, because sometimes we go into places like, what's that place we used to go years ago? Body Shop. Mm-hmm. And you see all these artistic things. Yeah, it's man. You get sense so? You're like, you think, wow. But to know you did that at home with the baby running around, no one stressing you out. I was amazed by it. And just the presentation, you know, the intricacy in it all, it's just fabulous. So, you know, I think we've made our point today with you, Mahawa, to some degree. I think we've got the message out. Yeah. Not for I shall be no more. Mm-hmm. Say, oh, designers, they do I shall be. Well, I don't, you know, I haven't got a wedding to go to, so I don't need an I shall be. No, I'm sure you need to wash tomorrow, right? We got the soap.
Alice says I'll definitely buy her product.
No, and
Alice!
And she will. She's got kids. And, you know, in fact, I'm really excited that she's even watching. So she's a specialist in the community. She's not somebody just to have a go. You know, she's there. She's a hero. Have a go, hero. Mm. Hey, Alice! So, I want to just finish off with you, Mahawa, and I just want you to just tell the community what plans Soap Connoisseur has for the community as well.
Okay.
Where are you going? Well, and what makes you, let's start one by one. Tell us more about where Soap Connoisseur is going to be in the next 2 years.
Well, our biggest plan is to actually take over Lush. That's actually my plan.
Let me make you laugh.
So you mean Lush the soap?
Yeah. Lush the soap.
You thought it was Lush coffee.
Okay. So you want to take over the soap? Lush.
Lush.
I don't know Lush.
Body Shop.
Oh, you know, really?
We want to sort of grow our business onto that scale. That's really our biggest plan.
That is in the next year or two?
In the next 2 to 5 years.
But I'm not an economics person, but if the amount of viewers who watch this show today buy, you would achieve that in a couple of months.
Thank you.
Do you know what I mean? We're talking about 2 years plan to take over a specific Lush. But if the viewers who are watching today, like I keep saying, put your money where your mouth is. When you keep saying you're ready to support, when you keep saying boom, bam, bam, it's time to buy. I make it my business to buy. Because the worst thing is to get caught out. You know, you say you want to support, but you're not even trying to buy your people's things. So at every stage I'm buying, I just want to know, to what extent are people who are watching really ready to play ball? Let's see.
Yeah.
So what I'm going to close up shop now with you, look in this camera.
Yeah.
You've got 30 seconds. Oh, we've got a surprise. Yeah. Oh.
Well, so I am a qualified beauty specialist as well, and as part of the Soap Connoisseur brand, one of the things we offer is actually facials and beauty treatments. And today we're giving away a free facial and a beauty treatment to one of
our customers.
Who's the lucky winner? Lucky winner! Lucky winner! Lucky winner! Lucky winner! Lucky winner!
So let's do that again. So Maha has just said, for today's show, Nasai Fashion TV, my show, yeah, you know that show, okay? She's giving away a free facial and beauty treatment to a lucky person. The next person who sends a message is going to get that facial. On your marks, get set. Treatment from the wonderful Soap Connoisseur Mahawa Kamara. So we're gonna keep our eyes out for the next, but I hope it's not an assault.
I hope it's not a man.
I hope it's not.
Yes, out. Please, me, yes. Samola. Buck put a comment, but he was 1 minute early before he actually the competition went on. Can we take some comments?
Oh,
yeah, before no, Sam,
I'm finished. This is for Samuela. Sammy, can you do half her face and half mine? What's the problem? I thought we were supposed to support each other.
Ali says, that's how you like kids.
And
Chris says, they'll make a perfect gift. Box says, Mawa, your attitude of professionalism is on point, and your marketing position is very impressive. I love the way you position your brand and business strategy. I must admit, you are indeed a true entrepreneur. Entrepreneurs are problem solvers, and that is exactly what I learned in your presentation today. Keep it up. Your brand will definitely go crazy. Very inspirational. Long live beloved Sierra Leone, Mama Salon, and much respect to Nasai TV and the crew. So that comment came from Bok Dumbuya. Yeah? Bok, 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 Bok. And Alice says, I need that face massage. Oh, Alice just missed it.
I'm
sorry, Alice. Sorry. And Samuel is dancing. Thank you. And Bok was saying that was supposed to be me. He wasn't coming. You posted it 1 second earlier, Bok. Sorry.
Bok, you know what? You just messed up there because I was going to go with you.
Yeah.
Just to get to know each other. And anymore? Okay, we're going to actually leave it there. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yes? So if people want to buy, where can they go and get?
So at the moment, our website is under construction. So we are launching the Soap Connoisseur in August, actually. So we said it on here first, actually. So we need to launch in August. But in the time being, you can go on our Facebook page, The Soap Connoisseur, and we have a shoppable store. We're also on Instagram, we're also on Twitter, so you can follow us, and we have shoppable stores on all our social media pages.
Wonderful.
And then you can also contact me directly as well if you're interested in any more products or you want to know more about your skin. And
you can also buy any products from me, yes. You can buy it for me from Mahawa as well, okay?
And if you want a discount, mention Nasai Fashion TV. Yes. Nasai Fashion TV! Nasai Fashion TV! Nasai Fashion TV!
I just want to finish before I come to an end. Could you bring our guests back on as we come to a close?
We're coming to close, but there's somebody I just want to say really thanks to you, Ice. Because if it wasn't because of you, I wouldn't have Abbas or Mahawa here with me today. So I really am grateful for the work that Ice did behind the scenes, you know, contacts and everything else. And Tad, I really have to apologize that Tad was unable to make today. I know he's the Don Dada himself, so Tad, no hard feelings. I know you have things going on today, so I do apologize. To the viewers that he's not able to make it today. But closing the show. Hi. Just want to say thank you so much for everything you've done for this show today. Thank you for your compassion, for your emotions, and you know the fact that you're ready to make a difference in the community on the international stage, especially when we're talking about fashion. Mahawa, it goes without saying that right now you're the cream of the crop, you know? And what you've done, and especially products like this, helping, you know, people who may not have necessarily the best skin in town, but also if you have got really good skin, this is something that you can just continue to replenish that and push that forward. The two of you have clearly shown that fashion is on the rise. Style is ready to be taken. The two of them are saying to you, I brought them to show you all that, not to I shall be normal in salon people they be soap. If you want an everyday soap, Mahawa is here. You probably buy 3-4 jeans a week, a year. We've got abs here. So I'm asking the community, from this day forward, make a conscious decision that every jean you wear is coming from this side. Take your £100 out your pocket and you might as well buy the soap for the rest of the year from this side. If that doesn't happen, we will continue to be behind. And I don't think it's going to be good for the community. I think we are lower than we've ever been for a very long time. And I think what makes it really worse is that we actually have the designers, we have the style, and there's people who are interested. So please, please, those who are watching, put it in your diary. Make a conscious decision that from this day forward, your jeans that you wear is going to have the trademark of the Sierra Leone. And the soap that you use to wash your skin and the cream that you use to rub your body is also going to have the trademark of a Sierra Leonean. Unless you guys do survive, change will never be near. I'm going to stop talking and I'm going to give Abbas say the last word and then I'll wish
you. Yeah, I'm actually honored to be here and I'm immensely proud of the job that NYSA is doing. You know, because it really struck me when you told me that you're doing this. I was really happy, you know, because you don't get to see Sierra Leone and, you know, who are really innovative, you know, inspiring, you know. So I was really, really happy. That's why I'm here tonight. And I'm really, really glad that you're taking this step. Because I look back from my time at uni, you know, like I've been struggling to come across Sierra Leoneans who are really, like, creative. Who are, like, I struggle. I'm getting really emotional saying this. Like, you go to, like, seminars, you don't see Sierra Leoneans, you know. So like seeing this, the first time I knew you, you know, I'm like, wow, I was really, really happy. I was just like wow, this is it, you know, this is what I was looking for, you know. And I'm glad and I hope and pray that you continue to exceed and the Sierra Leonean community embrace you and embrace all of us, and then we can put Mama Salon up there, you know, and praise God, you know.
Going
to close
the show. I want to just thank NYSA. I want to thank Ice.
Yes,
thank you for having me. Since I met NYSA. Nasa and I's from day one. They've always been on board. They've sat with me for 2 hours while I lecture them about skincare products. So they are amazing and, you know, they're fabulous. So all the salon people there, we still want to thank you for watching.
Thank you
for supporting this movement. And to Nasa, well done. Thank you so much for putting this in, giving us a platform.
Onwards, upwards.
Onwards, upwards.
There we go.